Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asian Newsline and 30 top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 4th of September. After productive Brunei visit, PM Modi arrived in Singapore for high-level discussions. Pakistan sticks to plans for new taxes on retail sector despite strike threat. India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday arrived in Singapore for the second leg of the two-nation visit. The Prime Minister is on a two-day official visit to Southeast Asian country on the invitation of his Singaporean counterpart Lawrence Wong. Both the leaders will review the progress of India-Singapore strategic partnership and exchange views on regional and global issues of mutual interest. PM Modi had earlier visited Brunei, where he held talks with Sultan Haji Hassan Al-Bolkiah. In a post on X, the Prime Minister said the talks were wide-ranging and included ways to further cement bilateral ties between the two nations. He added that India and Brunei are going to further expand trade ties, commercial linkages and people-to-people exchanges. Infusing fresh impetus to the Act East policy, both sides welcomed the elevation of bilateral ties to enhanced partnership. The Prime Minister, in an address, said India supports a policy of development and not expansionism, a veiled reference to China. Brunei is located near South China Sea, which is claimed almost entirely by Beijing. Thus, the visits are also being deemed as counter-outreach to Beijing's growing dominance in the region. And kicking off India's main opposition Congress party's campaign ahead of Jammu and Kashmir Assembly election, leader of opposition Rahul Gandhi on Wednesday promised to restore the statehood for the people in the region. He asserted that the withdrawal of its autonomous status has not only snatched the reasons of its identity, but also eroded the rights and resources of its people. Calling the lieutenant government a king, Rahul Gandhi accused the central government of giving the benefits meant for the people of the valley to outsiders. Taking a jibe over remarks by Prime Minister Modi that he is not biological and talks directly with God, Rahul Gandhi said that in this election, God has given him a direct message saying he speaks to the public and acts according to their wishes.
मगर पहली बार हिंदुस्तान के किसी स्टेट को रद्द करके लोगों का जो हक है वो छीना गया. पहली बार हुआ है. ऐसे हिंदुस्तान के इतिहास में, मॉडर्न इंडिया में ये काम पहले कभी नहीं किया गया है. तो सबसे पहले जम्मू कश्मीर को जो स्टेटहुड है वो वापस देना है, क्योंकि आपका सिर्फ स्टेट नहीं छीना गया, आपके अधिकार, आपका धन, सारा का सारा आपसे छीना जा रहा है.
Jammu and Kashmir has 90 assembly constituency. The upcoming elections will be the first in J&K since the abrogation of Article 370. The polling will be conducted in three phases on September 18, 25 and on 1st of October. The counting of votes will take place on 8th of October. Moving on, the Pakistan government has voted to implement new taxes on the retail sector as part of efforts to secure a $7 billion IMF loan. The move comes amidst growing public outrage over high taxes and electricity bills by traders. A report.
Pakistan's Finance Minister Mohammad Aurangzeb vowed on Tuesday to persevere with plans for new taxes on the retail sector despite strike threats as a step towards winning IMF board approval for a $7 billion loan. The taxes, in line with ambitious revenue targets, faced public backlash after they were introduced in the June budget. Aurangzeb said, "One thing I want to be very clear about, this is not going to be taken back." The comments follow nationwide strikes by retailers to demand withdrawal of the new tax scheme and high electricity rates. The latest of the last few months' protests against the new tariffs, taxes and inflation.
जो बिल बिजली के बिल हैं जो इतने ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा आ रहे हैं कि एक गरीब आदमी की पहुंच से बाहर हैं। दूसरी बात, एक दो ताजर दो स्कीम इन्होंने चलाई है जो हमें समझ नहीं आ रही है, क्योंकि कम से कम 20 से ज़्यादा टैक्स जो हैं वो बिजली के बिलों में इन्होंने लगा दिए हैं। तीसरी बात यह है कि ये अपनी शाखर्ची क्यों नहीं कम करते हैं।
लोग महंगाई की वजह से अपने बच्चों को पढ़ा नहीं सक रहे हैं, बिजली के बिल नहीं दे सक रहे हैं। महंगाई की वजह से हमारे लोगों का यकीन माने के कमर टूट गया, और ताजर जिसको कहते हैं कि ये पाकिस्तान की रीढ़ की हड्डी है, और इन्होंने रीढ़ की हड्डी पे वार किया है।
On Tuesday, Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif said the government was working to adopt IMF conditions and complete a loan program he hoped would be the South Asian nation's last. Reining in unresolved debt across Pakistan's power sector is a top concern of the IMF, which ended a $3 billion bailout in April that led to higher tariffs, hurting the poor and middle class, and cut household use for the first time in 16 years.
The U.S. House of Representatives Foreign Affairs Committee on Tuesday subpoenaed Secretary of State Antony Blinken, saying he has refused to appear before the panel to testify on the U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan in 2021. In a letter about the subpoena, Chairman Michael McQuill said Blinken must appear before the committee on September 19 or face contempt charges. State Department spokesperson Matthew Miller said Blinken was not currently available to testify on the dates proposed by the committee, but has proposed reasonable alternatives to comply with McQuill's request for a public hearing. He said Blinken had testified on Afghanistan before the Congress more than 14 times. He also said the State Department has provided the committee with nearly 20,000 pages of department records, multiple high-level briefings and transcribed interviews. The subpoena from McQuill's committee, which has been investigating the deadly and chaotic withdrawal from Afghanistan, comes as events surrounding the pullback became an increasingly politicized issue ahead of the November 5 elections. Moving on. Sri Lanka has announced an immediate visa-free policy for travellers from 38 countries. This decision follows a month-long period during which Sri Lanka issued visas on arrival due to issues with its e-visa system, which a foreign consortium had managed. Foreign Minister Ali Sabri said, as part of the move, Singapore's streamlined one-shop approach would be adopted. He said that the decision will help ease congestion at visa counters. The country of 22 million people, famed for its beaches, ancient temples and aromatic tea, saw its tourism industry pummeled first by the COVID-19 pandemic and then by a severe financial crisis last year that saw mass-scale protests and shortages of essentials such as fuel. The tourism industry has now witnessed a turnaround in 2023 with gradual signs of recovery. And Nepal's central bank will be printing new banknotes featuring a revised map which incorporates the disputed territories with India. Nepali media portal Nepal Khabar has reported. The Nepal Rashtra Bank has begun the process of printing the banknotes with the map, which includes the territories of Lipu Lake, Kalapani and Limpia Dhura. The bank spokesperson Diliram Pokhrel was quoted as saying by the media outlet. He added, the 100 rupee note with the updated map will be issued within 6 months to a year. The development comes months after former Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dehal had approved the inclusion of the disputed map in rupees 100 currency note. Notably, incumbent Prime Minister Oli in his previous term had amended the constitution by incorporating a new map in the preamble constitution, including the three Indian territories. New Delhi had rejected the map and said artificial enlargement of claims is not based on historical facts or evidence and is not tenable. And thousands of Rohingya Muslims have fled to Bangladesh in recent months, Bangladeshi authorities have informed, as violence intensified in Myanmar's Rakhine state as fighting between Myanmar's ruling junta and the Arakan army, a powerful ethnic militia drawn from the Buddhist majority, continues to worsen. Talking to Reuters, Mohammad Shamsud Doiza, a senior Bangladesh government official in charge of refugees, said that they have information that around 8,000 Rohingya have crossed into Bangladesh recently, mostly over the last 2 months. De facto Foreign Minister
Mohammad Tuhid Hussain said, while Bangladesh expresses sympathy, the country no longer the capacity to provide humanitarian shelter to additional refugees. It is not possible to fully seal the border, he said, adding that efforts will be made to prevent further infiltration. Over 1 million Rohingya currently live in overcrowded camps in southern Bangladesh with little hopes of returning to Myanmar, where they are largely denied citizenship and other basic rights. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.